Thanks for tuning in to this Alaska Insight Web Extra. We're continuing our conversation with mayoral incumbent candidate Ethan Berkowitz and challenger Rebecca Logan. And thanks to my guests for sticking around. I want to ask you both a few more questions, so thanks for staying here. Both of you are on record saying you're not in favor of Proposition 1. Mm-hmm. Is that correct?
Yes.
The so-called bathroom ordinance that would regulate some municipal facilities by biological sex at birth. How did you arrive at your position? Let's start with you, Mr. Berkowitz.
I think that I respect the right of individuals to make determinations about their own lives, and if people feel more comfortable using one set of facilities as opposed to another, that's up to them, and that's respecting their liberty. I also feel that one of the strengths of a democracy is we protect the rights of a minority even if it's publicly unpopular. And I never want us to succumb to stereotyping and prejudice. And I will always make sure that I'm on the side of the people who are vulnerable and being attacked.
Ms. Logan, same question to you. You're not in favor of it. How did you come to that decision?
It's a public safety issue for me. And then when you look at it from the role of the mayor, your job as mayor is to protect everybody, right? Not one group over the other. And actually, when you say stereotyping, it automatically insults the group that is behind the yes on one. I've met with both of those groups. And as mayor, it's your job to protect both. So the way that we've gone about it is that we always have a winner and a loser. The assembly passed legislation that offended about tens of thousands of Anchorage residents. If yes on one passes, tens of thousands of Anchorage residents will not be happy, and that's a horrible way to look at long-term policy. You've got to get those groups together and try to come up with some public policy that can accommodate the majority of concerns for both groups. If that doesn't happen, we're going to have a lawsuit, and that's not what we need in this city right now.
Let's stay with you for just a moment. What in your mind should equality look like for Anchorage?
I guess it's on how you define equality, but with regards to public safety, everybody has the right to feel safe, right? And so again, if you're addressing one group and not the other, you're not doing your job.
Mr. Berkowitz, what should equality be for Anchorage?
You know, we regularly pledge allegiance to a flag and we say it's with liberty and justice for all. And that means everybody gets treated equally under the law with respect and with dignity. And there are some underlying values that are reflected in our Constitution and our way of life. Equality is core to them. Not equality of outcome, but equality of opportunity and equality of treatment.
The city is holding its first vote by mail election. Ballots are out to residents now. Are you in favor of this new method? Are there improvements that you would make? Is it the best way to get more people to turn out for future elections, Mr. Berkowitz?
Well, I hope it works out well. And I say that because I didn't anticipate being part of the guinea pig election that's part of here. But, you know, I look at the reasons why the assembly put this forward, and they were very concerned about low voter turnout, and they were looking for ways to maybe increase turnout. And I think there's some advantages, too, to this kind of election. Having been in the more typical kind of election, they're dominated by last-second smear ads. And, you know, this allows for a more substantive debate and requires campaigns to address issues throughout a candidacy rather than just at the very end.
Ms. Logan, your thoughts about mail-in ballots?
I've talked to people who really like it, and I've talked to people who really hate it. I think it's a developing theme, right? I mean, if it's meant to increase voter turnout, that's what we really have to judge the whole prospect by. But right now, we have really low turnout. We're 1 week into this, and we've had quite a low number. We only have 13,000 ballots as of last night. That's pretty low.
All right. We've only got a couple of minutes left. What do you think Anchorage should be known for, or will be known for, in a decade? I guess we should start with you now. What will Anchorage be known for in a decade, and what would you like for it to be known for in a decade?
I hope that we're known for having a really strong private sector economy like we've had up until we hit the bottom on oil prices, right? Because when you have a really thriving private sector economy, that means that you're doing other things very well, that you're, you know, public safety is being handled well and all the roles of government, because businesses are interested in investing here and it's a good investment climate. And then when you have a thriving private sector, you have, you know, those are the people who take care of less fortunate people in our city through our nonprofits, you know, and they've been able to fund, the private sector has really been able to fund the nonprofits here. And when they're weak, then the nonprofits are weak.
And I'm just reflecting on some of the people I've known that made Anchorage what it is and how they came or were here for generations. And they had this indomitable faith that this place was special and unique. And it was north to the future. It was a crossroads of the world. Now we're the most diverse city in the country. I want people to look at Anchorage and say, this is an incredible place for us to live, to work, to play. But it's got to be ultimately a really cool city to live in. That's how we're going to make sure that people who are here stay here, and people who are interested in coming here come here. Because if you want to talk about what it means in an economy into the future, is businesses come to where populations are. This isn't the old days where populations moved to the factory. The factories now come to the people. And I think if we have our own unique character and we have a high quality of education and infrastructure, we're going to be the kind of place that people look to and say, we're going to do things the Anchorage way. Anchorage has it figured out.
I'm going to blow up our timing because I'd like to get one more question in. And it's about people with disabilities in the city. We've had a lot of snow this year. Sidewalks are tough for people in wheelchairs. There are areas of the city that are dangerous for pedestrians. How would you work to fix that? What's the future plan if you're reelected that you would work on to make the city more accessible for people with disabilities?
Yeah, I've worked with people in the disability community trying to improve access, and winter cities are tough under any circumstances. One of the things that we've tried to do this year, and we put more resources towards plowing sidewalks, and that enables people to be more mobile inside their neighborhoods. We have to coordinate better with the state, so when we plow a sidewalk, they don't overplow with the street. But we need to make sure that facilities are more accessible. I think of the PAC, for example, right now. We have a lot of structures in this town that were built before the ADA came into effect. And I'm not talking about chapter and verse of the ADA. I'm talking about simple ways for people to get up and down stairs. And we need to do more in the future of Anchorage to make sure that we're a more inclusive community. We should be proud of the fact that we have more inclusive playgrounds than any other city in the country right now, and we're on the leading edge. And so there's some things we're doing well. We're going to have to continue with that effort.
Ms. Logan, what would you do to help people with disabilities?
I think you've got to strengthen the programs that deal with people with disabilities. I've been involved with Special Olympics here for 25 years, and that's a great program where there is an entire group of people, of citizens in the community, who are partners with people in Special Olympics, right? And I know Challenge Alaska does the same thing. And you've got the Hope Cottages, so you have to work with those individual agencies who are frontline on providing service and figure out what they need. And that's, in my mind, those are, you know, that's where resources should be directed, is to help people who can't help themselves all the time, right? And to make sure that they can do what they need to do.
Or as Jim Balmacy from Special Olympics would say, oh yeah.
Well, thank you both so much for being here this evening. Incumbent candidate Ethan Berkowitz and challenger Rebecca Logan.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.